All right, raccoons, before we dig into things, I need you to listen up. Give me your attention for just a second as we talk through the transition to second semester. First, I just want to go over a few quick reminders for you all and talk a little bit about the weather and lunch and all that stuff. First is community commitments. The best thing I can remind you is you're reviewing all the community commitments today. Nothing new, but if we can remember, our IDs are essential, especially if you're leaving campus and coming back to campus or you're arriving late. You need to show your ID as you enter the building to a staff member that's there that's checking the ID. You don't need them if you're coming before school or after school, but if you're transitioning between periods, like you go from Block B over to lunch during from East Campus, you need to make sure you show your ID. If you're coming in late, you got to show your ID. So make sure you get your ID on you. If you lost it, right, we can help you get a new one and charge it to your account and go from there. So you need your ID. That's been something we've been struggling with a little bit more. Remember, that's an expectation. That's a safety expectation. It's not meant to make your life miserable. So the people checking your ID certainly don't need your attitude if you forget it. Fair enough? They're raccoons too. Second celebration. I was just at the Building Trades 3 house. We had a second home being built this year. Over the weekend, we celebrated the completion of the fall home. And now this year, with the number of interests we have, we're building a second home this winter and spring. And it was awesome celebration for them. And some of them are back from there because, well, the weather's not exactly the best to build a house today. But super great work there. And why I'm sharing that with you is we build a house every semester. But it's an example of commitment. What is your commitment as you go into the second semester? You get a chance to reflect on that a little bit today. Second thing is accountability. Accountability, accountability. And accountability comes in different ways. It comes with rules. It comes with self-accountability. It comes with people holding you accountable. But I want to push on us just a little bit today when we think about lunch. Lunch, lunch, lunch. Seniors, you can go out to lunch. You know that. But I will tell you this. While the roads are passable, the side roads are very slippery, and the parking lot's super slippery as well. Yes, people are out there salting. Our grounds crew is working incredibly hard, but it's continuing to rain, so the salt they put down, every 15 to 20 minutes, it just refreezes. So it is slippery out there, so hold yourself accountable. If you don't feel comfortable maybe driving or you don't have enough time to maybe get to where you normally go for lunch or whatever it might be, right? The roads are passable, you can go, but maybe you make the self-decision to stay here for lunch today. It will be slower regardless of what you decide, and you're expected to be in your block seat on time. You don't want your second tardy of the day if you were tardy this morning because maybe you were a little slow to get things rolling with the ice there. We shouldn't rush to get places on time. We need to stay safe, but we need to make decisions that we can own that help set us up for success. So if we're a young driver or we know it's going to take longer and we're going to be rushing back and we got a lot of tardies already, maybe we just stay in for lunch today. I'm sure Chef Jeff is having something great. All right, transitioning into the second semester. Here we go. It's a fun time of year, even though it's winter, but it's a good time to reflect on where we're at. Freshmen, you just finished your first semester of high school, and that is a huge feat. Maybe your grades aren't where you want them to be. Maybe you got all A pluses. Maybe you need to identify some supports to help you get through the year in a successful way. And maybe if you're doing really well, it's time to start challenging and pushing yourself as you think about course registration and all of that. Sophomores, you're coming upon what I think is the most crucial part of your high school journey in the sense of picking classes for your junior year. On Monday, we have another community meeting where we'll sit down and walk through the registration of courses for next year. Sophomores, this is your chance to start thinking about not just classes, but programs. The IB program, the building trades program, whatever it might be, youth apprenticeship, dual enrollment. While maybe some of these opportunities don't open up till senior year, it is important that you have the classes and you set yourself up for success to have access to those programs when you want to go and pursue them. So sophomores, it's incredibly important. There's still time. If you need to make an appointment with your counselor through the You Can Book Me app, make sure you do that. Don't procrastinate because course request window opens on Monday and then it will close just a week afterwards. So keep that in mind. Juniors, you're about ready to become seniors, and it's incredibly important that you, again, think about the opportunities that are going to build your portfolio for whatever you're trying to do next, whether that's your portfolio that you want your four-year or two-year colleges to see, or if it's an employer or your military recruiters, or if you're starting to think about apprenticeship and you're going to the union halls and all of that. Your transcript, your discipline record, your letters of recommendation all tell the story of who you are. And this is the time where you can turn the corner if maybe we're down the wrong path. People won't judge you based off the last thing you did. They'll judge you based off of your trends. So it's not the time to say, oh, I want an easy senior year, or I don't think I want to take another AP class. It's a time to reflect on making sure your transcripts and making sure your profile looks as strong as it is to whoever it is that you want to work with next, whether that's a university or a job site. You're in control of that right now. You're painting that picture. So how are you setting yourself up for success when you start to display that to universities, employers, apprenticeships, or to the military? Think about it. Seniors, it can be easy to think it's almost done because it is almost done. But what we find is maybe our anxiety goes up a little bit as we think about transitioning from becoming a raccoon to whatever's next. If you need any help or support in that process, you need to reach out to myself, your associate principals, your counselors, your trusted adults, because it is nerve-wracking to go from what has been home for 3.5 years to a new start. We're going to celebrate what was a successful 4 years. We got so much stuff planned, and our team is already meeting on Thursday to start planning graduation. But you need to think about what it is that you need to be set up for success for that transition. Next week, you'll get the opportunity to share a little bit about what you need, whether you want to learn more about security and living on your own, whether you want to learn more about scholarships, how to fill out the federal financial aid stuff, whatever it is to help with that transition. And as we begin to enter the season of the last season, the last this, the last test, the last whatever, right? Remember to embrace each moment that you got, because the high school journey is 704 days, not just 7 semesters. You got 80 some odd days to go. So I'm going to transition it now to our Ms. Mieske and a few of our student representatives to talk about putting first things first and how we can begin to prioritize the big rocks in our life as we think about second semester, no matter where we are in this 704-day journey. So here we go.
All right. Hello, everybody. I'm Mrs. Mieske. I teach Leadership 1 and 2, and I brought some students with me today.
Oh, restart. All right. Good morning, everyone. I'm Mrs. Mieske. I teach Leadership 1 and 2, and I brought some students here with me today just to talk a little bit about putting first things first. So as we start the new semester, we want to take some time to pause and think about the upcoming months and how we can prioritize. So habit 3, putting first things first, helps us do just that. Putting first things first is all about prioritizing the most important things in your life, the most important people, the most important things. So one of those key concepts of habit 3 is big rocks. So we have some of our big rocks here, family, work, school, sports. There's a whole bunch of different rocks that you may find as your big priorities in life, and how you continue to prioritize them to be most successful, not only here at school, but also in life. But first, we're going to watch a video from our friends Zoe and Nicole to hear a little bit more about prioritizing and putting the big rocks first.
Hey, what do we have here?
Today, we're talking about putting first things first, and this is our great experiment.
Yes, Skittles.
Not so fast. This bowl represents 1 week of your life, and your job is to get all the important things into this bowl.
Okay, so this is everything I do in a week.
Yeah, and you have to fit all these in without going over the edge.
Okay, so I have to make it fit without going over the top?
Yes.
Family's pretty important to me. Friends, I love my friends. School, obviously have to fit that in. Sports, I love to ski, of course. Okay, this is getting there. Work, oh no.
So, whatever doesn't fit under the brim, you just can't have it. You gotta prioritize.
What about me and being healthy?
Yeah, so that's what, like half of your life?
But I need these. I need me time and health.
Well then, you're gonna have to do something different. You're gonna have to rearrange. You have to prioritize what you need.
Hey, Nicole.
All right, so let's take the big rocks out. Do you remember what this habit is called?
Put first things first.
Great, so how are you gonna do this differently? All right, so we gotta dump out your daily activities and put the important things in first.
Big rocks go first. Family, friends,
me help. Goodness. School. Work. Oh, there we go. And sports.
So now you can put in the rest of your daily activities.
I'm still over the brim.
Well, then we have to.
What about these? Like, this is me brushing my teeth. This is me doing my hair. This is a couple minutes on Snapchat. This is me on TikTok.
Yeah, you lost these things, but you still have these. This is your hygiene. This is your social media. This is your talking with friends. And yes, you may not respond to your friends immediately on Snapchat or text them back right away, but you still have the important things in your bucket here. It's not going to end well if you sacrifice family for Snapchat or school for a little extra time on TikTok.
Okay, that's true. I should be prioritizing my big things instead of my little things.
Exactly. What are the big things in your life?
Thank you, Zoe and Nicole, for the fabulous example of putting first things first. One of the most important things you can do to help yourself put first things first is identify your big rocks. Your big rocks are the most important relationships, tasks, and activities. One thing that may help you identify your big rocks is by recognizing your various roles. One role you have is student, family member. Another might be athlete, club member, musician, artist, employee. Once you have identified your roles, it can make it easier for you to determine your most important things, or your big rocks. Scheduling your big rocks first each week allows you to spend more time on the important things and also have time for the daily things. Now it's time to talk it over. What are the big rocks you will prioritize? All right. All right. Thank you, Zoe and Nicole, for sharing that awesome example with us. I brought some students here to share a little bit about their big rocks and things that they're prioritizing as they think about, for some of them, their last semester here at OHS, and some of them are just starting out their journey. So I'm going to turn it over to Clayton to share a little bit about his big rocks.
Yeah, so I'm Clayton. I'm a senior here, and my biggest rocks at the moment really revolve around college. Even though I still have things going on here at the high school, obviously I still have classes and I still have like sports coming up. My biggest priorities are like getting FAFSA done, so making sure I can get that federal aid, making sure I meet roommates for, to dorm with in college, and getting the finances down for housing and for any things I might need for the classes there, like books and supplies. And so a lot of my biggest priorities come down to things revolving around college and getting ready for the next step. And
Hi, I'm Andrew, and I'm a junior, and one of the things I prioritize is sports, and something I do every single day to do that is I go to Old Power, and another thing I do is I have rack and performance on my schedule and just make sure that I get better mentally and physically every single day.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Gracie, and I'm a sophomore, and one of my big rocks is my relationships with my family. And I prioritize that by having once a week, I plan out either going shopping with my sister or having dinner. And that's because she doesn't live with me anymore, so we can still have that relationship.
Hi, I'm Ariana. I'm a freshman, and one of my big rocks is school and my upcoming sophomore courses. So for me, I'm interested in business, so looking into all those business courses, but also making sure I'm getting my graduation requirements and just staying on top of it is one of my big priorities.
All right, so we are going to take a little bit of time for you to think about those big rocks in your life, the priorities. So we all have lots of things that fill our day. But the main important thing that we want to remember is that if we prioritize and schedule our big rocks first, then those other, we have time for those other things, but we make sure that we are scheduling our priorities and making sure that the most important things come first. So I'm going to give you we're going to set a timer for about 5 minutes, and you are going to get a chance to just kind of brainstorm. Think about thinking back to your roles as student, athlete, artist, employee, family member, friend, all the different roles that you take on. I want you to think about those roles and then think about those big rocks in your life currently. As you think about second semester, and we're gonna take about 5 minutes to just kind of do a quick write on those priorities. Go ahead.
Thank you.
All right. Oh. We good? All right. So we are, I just had a chance to walk around a little bit and just check in with a few students. And some of the things that came up often were self-care and taking care of myself as I'm going into this next season. And I think that's super important to prioritize. And when you think about your schedule, looking at it week to week and adjusting it daily, scheduling that time for yourself, scheduling that time for your relationships that are most important, those are all really great things to continue to do. So when we think about this, habit one is being proactive. That's all about making those choices. Habit two is all, it's beginning with the end in mind. It's all about your vision. And then habit three is putting first things first. That's where the action is taken. When you take action on the things that are important to you and align with your vision. So as you start second semester, we all wish you just a fabulous semester and just thinking about how you continue to work towards those goals. So keep putting first things first and have a great rest of your day.
Cue the music!